All right.
Yeah, that was good. You're done with the guitars for the album?
Done.
How have you felt? I mean, since we just did solos, how have you felt about that whole process? Because, I mean, there were no solos from you on the first, on P2.
Mm-hmm.
And you, of course, had a solo on your track on Clear.
Mm-hmm.
This time you've got three solos going into that.
Yep.
Has lead playing been a focus of yours in that kind of time period? Has it been something you've been looking forward to?
I mean, I can't say that it's ever been a primary focus of mine as a guitar player, but it is something that I wanted to sort of face on this album, just as a test. I mean, I'm always trying to better myself in different ways. And I do say that was one of the main things that I sort of look back on Periphery 2, and I'm proud of it. Scarlet and a couple other songs, but it always kind of bothered me after the matter, you know. There were some great solos on that record, and I got stuck with that damn Guthrie Govan solo. So like,
you mean having to
emulate it live? Right, yeah. Having to play it live, so I was like, damn, I got to play this solo live every night. And I think I've played that solo like 150 times live or something, but I don't have any solos to call my own that I play live. So it's kind of driven by that, you know. Just try and work as much on my lead playing as possible. This, I think it's safe to say that compared to any of the Periphery material we put out before, has been completely collaborative. Mm-hmm. You know, it's just like, from the writing to the mixing. I mean, we haven't even mixed yet, but we already have all this, you know, all these opinions flying around based on mixing. Mm-hmm. It's just like, you can't move an inch in this band without there being some sort of collaborative opinion or feedback, which mm-hmm. is a bad thing, but you know, it's a great thing if you want to have the best possible representation of the band. And I think that's what we have now. It's like, the styles are sort of becoming integrated, you know. Mm-hmm. Like, Misha's writing a lot of stuff that sounds like me. Jake's writing a lot of stuff that sounds like Misha and me, and like, I'm writing a lot of stuff that sounds like Jake and Misha. It's like the voices are all starting to become blended, so mm-hmm. to speak, you know.
Oh, I think it's really cool.
And I'm trying to emulate your vibrato.
You're doing a good job.
There was a very deliberate attempt from the very beginning to say, hey, vocals need to take a bigger sort of forefront in the music. Mm-hmm. Saying that is one thing. Doing that is much more challenging when you have all these other guitar players and instrumentalists in the band. Letting go of your parts or restructuring parts or having your riffs cut from a song, mm-hmm. which definitely happened to me, and it happened to everyone. You know, it's all, at the end of the day, it's for the greater good, and by that I mean the song. And, mm-hmm. and you know, I think we paid more attention this time to sort of having songs based around vocals. Mm-hmm. You know, there's still these long wanky songs on the album. I mean, good wanky. all wanky is good. No, I mean, there are songs on the album where vocals came first, and that was sort of unprecedented mm-hmm. for us. We'd never had that before.
So one really notable aspect of the recording process of this album has been the puns, mm-hmm. and I feel like you've really taken it to the next level with the puns. And
thank you.
Is this something you've been working on? You know,
yeah,
coming
actually,
into the studio.
Oddly enough, yeah.
Who would you say your pun influences are? Like your pun stars, as it were. I mean, I know there's been certain musicians on the road that you've had. Real good relationships.
Influences with puns, that's kind of hard to say. It's like asking Michael Jordan who's favorite basketball player. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? It's just like, you can't ask the best who the best are.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
It's rude, I'm sorry.
It's rude, it's okay.
I really apologize.
I mean, I have inspiration that I draw from. Mm-hmm. You know, I spend a lot of time alone.
Mm-hmm. I mean, at this point, I think you're probably legible to start having your puns on PunHub and, you know, other amateur pun sites.
Yeah, I hope so.
Is that something you're going to be focusing on the downtime after this record?
I think that's the next frontier. Mm-hmm. Now that I've mastered guitar and I've mastered the art of just being generally good at many things, mm-hmm. I think you know, amateur pun maybe, professional pun maybe, mm-hmm. the next step for me. I think I've got a foot in the door.
Yeah.
You know, I know a lot of actors and directors in LA and, mm-hmm. and the Valley and things like that. So, fingers crossed.
Fingers crossed, man.
Fingers crossed.
I'm rooting for you.
Thanks, dude.
Something I've really noticed as producer on this album is that the... I can't do it.
Okay.
Something I've really noticed as the producer on this album is that the... I can't do it. I'm trying to say the quality of the puns has been really high.
Get it out, dude. Get it
you
out.
You can't do that straight face. Okay.
Right.
It was fine the first time. Okay. So
sick.
During the recording of this album, there's been a really, really high level. I can just hear my voice sounding great. You know, being the producer's chair for this album, I feel like the quality of the puns has been a lot higher than on previous albums. I mean,
thank you.
I don't know if. Very serious. Thank you.
Thank you.
So one thing with this album that I think people are really going to take note of is that the quality of the puns has been just extremely high, and I think you've already been at the forefront of that. And
fuck!
So on this album, or at least during the making of this album, I feel like the quality of the puns has been extremely high. And goddamn, I keep So through the course of this album, I feel like you've become really adept with the tracking of the puns. Like, you got very good at the...
tracking!
Dude, I was gonna say, you got really good at pun chins.
Oh my god. Pun chins? Oh my god. Oh, this is tough, man. I don't know if this is gonna happen. Okay.